Hey guys, I am back. I am starting videos again. I didn't think I would be starting videos again, but here I am. Also, excuse what I look like. I feel like crap and I just got off work and I didn't put any makeup on for work today. So yeah, I'm back. I'm going to be filming again. So many things have changed since I was last on YouTube and making videos, so many things. So we will kind of get into that. One thing you'll be able to see on the title is I am no longer married, because you know, it'll say nighttime routine, single mom, nighttime routine. So yeah, big things have happened since I was last on here, which is one of the reasons I haven't been on in over a year. But yeah, so I just got off work. I'm gonna take you through our nighttime routine now that the kids and I don't live at home anymore. We have our own house now. So I will take you guys through that. You can kind of see what our routine is. I'm about to go pick up my kids. My grandma watches them while I'm at work. So I'm gonna go pick up my kids. It is 4 o'clock. I got off a little late today, which is gonna change a little bit soon because I'm starting a new job in 2 weeks. I am starting at the hospital soon, so I'll be working 3/12s, which, I mean, I'll still have a nighttime routine. I'll just pick my kids up when I get off at 7 on those days, unless it's a night they stay at their dad's, which they stay at their dad's a couple nights every other week. They'll stay like 2 nights, sometimes 3 that week. But yeah, unless he's working a crazy schedule, then they'll stay once or twice. I don't know, it changes. It's just when he's available that week. But yeah, so it'll change a little bit when I start there. I'll be home more. We're gonna be homeschooling. So many homeschooling videos with Sophia being in kindergarten this coming year. And then Easton will start some preschool stuff this year because he's 2. But yeah, let me take you on to our nighttime routine. I'm gonna go pick up the kids and I will see you guys when we get home.
No, let me out there.
Oh, you want the...
Hi guys. So, we are on the way home. We are trying to go home.
I'm not looking at you.
We are trying to film. I'm trying to film. I'm sweating right now. Stop. And we are trying to go home. And we changed the houses.
We did. Now we're going to go home.
Right,
so see you when we get home.
See you when we get home. Peace out.
Alright, so we just got home and there's my cat, Avi. But when we get home, I just kind of put my stuff down, put it up, give Avi some love. We got her when we moved into this house and I am surprised about how in love I am with her. But yeah, so that's Avi. And of course, Easton had to have some fruit snacks because this kid is obsessed with fruit snacks. And then they're gonna play and I'm gonna turn on some Mickey Mouse for Easton. That's literally his favorite show ever. And Sophia will watch whatever that makes him happy. So I'm gonna turn that on so they can play while I make dinner and watch their show. All right, so now I'm starting on dinner and this honestly is not the healthiest meal. I've actually been working very hard at eating healthy, counting all my macros, doing all those things, and have lost a lot of the baby weight from Easton. But I saw this video of this recipe on YouTube and I thought it looked really good. So I'm gonna make it tonight and give myself a little bit of a cheat meal. It's kind of a hard day at work. So we're gonna go ahead and make this meal. I'm cutting up some onion, gonna saute that with some garlic, and then use that pasta sauce and make a little sauce with that and some cream cheese and then some bow tie pasta, put all that together with spinach in it. It was really good. I can leave the recipe down below in the description box if anyone wants to try it out. It was super simple and quick to make, but super delicious, and it made a ton for leftovers. Thank you. So I don't know if anyone remembers Sophia from my previous videos, but she loves helping me in the kitchen and pretty much anything I'm doing. So she was helping me cook dinner. She's literally such a little mommy and loves helping in the kitchen, cleaning, her brother, everything. So we're gonna get that made up and she's gonna help me put it all together, and then I'll show you guys what it looks like when it's done. And yes, Avi is on the counter. I cannot break her from it. She never gets in any of the food, and I'm constantly taking her down from the counter, but no matter how hard I try, she constantly has to be where we are at. You'll see that when we're eating dinner later. She is so clingy for what I thought a cat was gonna be like. This is how it turned out. It was so good. Sophie and I both loved it. Easton ate a little bit, but he has not really been feeling well, so he didn't eat too much, but it was definitely a delicious pasta. So you got the forks?
Yeah. And the spoon?
Just a fork, baby. I have a fork already.
Okay.
So just for, one for you and one for Bubs. Good girl, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Is it good?
Yeah.
And like I was saying earlier, there is Avi chilling on the table. She, like I said, never gets in the food. She never bothers anyone. She just lays there and is obsessed with being where we are. So we're gonna eat dinner and catch up on our day. Easton's really starting to join the conversation too about things he did during the day and things that he liked. His vocabulary has flourished. It is just phenomenal. But yeah, so we're gonna catch up on our day, talk about what they did while they were with their mamaw.
Is he
good? Toad? So we are done with dinner. If it was bath night, just like every other night, we would be taking a bath right now, but it's not bath night. So we're gonna play for a little bit. And we actually have to go to bed early tonight because I have to get them up really early in the morning. Get them up at 4:45, so we're gonna go to bed within the hour. It's 6:30 right now, so I'm gonna get in bed by 7:30. But yeah, so we're going to play for a little bit, put some lotion on, clean their faces up from the pasta that they ate, brush teeth and all that. So but yeah, normally I don't have to get them up super early in the morning, because where I moved to, my grandma lives really close, so she normally just comes and, hang on a minute, please. She normally just comes and will get back in bed when she gets to my house that early in the morning. But she is staying at my sister's, so we're going to stop for just a minute, please. So we're going to wake up really early, and I'm gonna take them to her at my sister's house. So she's having a sleepover over there tonight. But yeah, so we're gonna play and all that, and I'll show you the rest of our routine. All right, so once dinner is done, I will go ahead and start on the dishes. I try to get them all washed as soon as we get done with dinner. That way I don't have to worry about it later once I'm sat down and relaxed. I realize if I don't sit down when I get home, then I'm more apt to getting everything done. Once I sit down and I turn on a show or I get comfy, I'm not gonna get up and clean anymore. So I try and get everything done before I sit down to relax. So we're gonna go ahead and get these washed. Sometimes I get them put away if they've dried, but if not, then I usually will put them away the next day, but at least they are washed and clean and I don't have to worry about it for the rest of the night. Also, excuse how this turned out filming. I have to get back into remembering how to turn my phone for filming, and I wasn't thinking about it, so it did this weird thing when I was editing it, but I will get back in the groove of things and hopefully get a little bit better
camera quality and maybe even get a camera here soon. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and get the kids' jammies and start getting them ready for bed. They share a room, so their clothes are all together. And this is the lotion that I put on them every night. It has melatonin and other stuff in it, and it smells good, and it just works. And this is Sophia's TikTok of changing clothes. And then after we get lotioned up, get jammies on, we like to brush our teeth. Easton is still fighting me on letting me do it. He wants to do it all by himself, but of course, he needs a little help from mommy. So when that is all done, it is around 7 o'clock, and I'll let the kids pick out a few books and we will sit in our reading chair, as we call it, or the chinchilla chair. It's not actually chinchilla, but there's just this joke that somebody saw it and said it looked like a chinchilla chair. So we sit in our chair and we read our books together, whatever books the kids picked out that night. And we actually, I think, read 6 books this night, but my phone ended up dying, so I wasn't able to film anything after the first book or second book. But yeah, so we read, and then once we are done reading, Sophia and I will do her devotional together. It's just a little girl's devotional. Easton will watch Mickey Mouse, and I'll read this to Sophia, and then I ask her some questions and ask her stuff about her day, and we write her thoughts on it and write what she's feeling that day down so that we can go back and read it later together, or I can just look upon it later and kind of see what she was going through at that time. Once we get done doing that, I'll usually sit on the couch for a little bit with the kids and watch some shows. But since we had to go to bed early, we snuggled for a little bit on the couch a couple minutes, and I went ahead and put them in their room. These are their bunk beds that they sleep in. They go to bed really easy. I just lay Easton down, tell him goodnight and I love him, give So some kisses, and they lay down. It's pretty simple. So yeah, that's it.
Okay guys, so that is basically our night. I am going to go take a bath and relax and get ready for bed. I have to be up at 4 to get ready for work. So, and then get the kids up at like 4:45. Yeah, I think I might do a different, like, get unready with me, get ready for bed kind of video. Maybe when I don't have the kids, like a different relaxing one, more in depth what I do for bed. But that's pretty much our night routine. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm excited to be back, and I will see you guys soon. Bye.